Hello and welcome. In this presentation, we are going to take a look at some basic notions of PLC, which means that we are going to answer the questions, what is PLC and how does it work? So what is a PLC? PLC stands for a programmable logic controller. It is a control device which is built similarly to a computer and consists of a power supply unit, relay units for inputs and outputs, central units with a programmable microprocessor, and an internal memory. A very important thing is that, contrary to simple programmable systems, where the controlling process is determined by the elements used in the circuit, in PLC, this process is supervised by a program stored in the memory of the device. Now, what are the main units of a PLC? A PLC consists of an input side comprising modules with 8, 16 or 32 inputs, depending on the model. The main task of this unit is to convert signals sent from neighboring devices, for example electrical signals, into digital signals which can be interpreted by the PLC. A common feature for indicating the status of a given input are LED indicators. This allows for a fast problem recognition and reaction if any of the inputs is not working properly. For the proper management of input signals, PLCs use multiplexers. Multiplexers select one of many analog or digital input signals and forward the selected input into a single line. We have discussed the input side. Now we will look at the output side. Now the output side is also divided into modules with 8 or 16 binary outputs. This part of the circuit typically contains transistors and amplifiers. And the status of a given output may be signaled by a LED indicator or by a bulb indicator. Now we will take a look at the way a PLC works. PLC works in programming cycles. It means that it first reads the status at the inputs, then goes to processing, and then based on the program that is in its internal memory and based on the data that it has uploaded at the beginning of the cycle, it controls the outputs and executes any commands. What does it mean in practice, and why is it so important that we understand the way PLC works? Say that we have a program with 4 outputs and we add a simple condition that if the first output is actuated, the second one cannot be actuated at the same time. In our course, we will see this situation with the automatic gate system, when one output stands for the opening of the gate and the other for the closing of the gate. And understandably, we don't want the program to try to open and close the gate at the same time. Now, here is an example of a common error. When we start our program, the PLC reads the status of all the inputs and outputs and decides that it is safe to open the gate and it is safe to close the gate because at this point nothing has happened yet. We move to the second stage of processing and ask the program to open the gate. The program begins to open the gate, but PLC does not go back from this stage to here to store a piece of information that the gate is now being opened. So for as far as the input status is concerned, for the PLC nothing has changed. And when we ask the program at this stage to close the gate, the program will try to do it. We will have a very strange situation when a program will try to open and close the gate at the same time. Of course, this is an error that can be handled with a set of conditions added at the connecting lines between the blocks, and we will show you how to do it, but to be able to write such a program, we have to know how PLC works and how to address such a problem when it occurs. When we talk about PLCs in automation, we would rarely see a single PLC unit. Rather, we would see a PLC network. To give you just a basic idea what a PLC network might look like, we will just briefly go over these elements in here. So we have an operator control station, a master PLC, two or more slave PLCs, a control panel with an external display. Of course, each of the PLCs can have its own external display. A DPASI link and devices connected to it. For those of you who don't know what an ASI link is, the full name is Actuator Sensor Interface, and this is an industrial networking protocol used in PLC, DCS and PC-based automation systems. It is designed for connecting simple field input-output devices in discrete manufacturing and process applications using a single two-conductor cable. When we talk about simple field input-output devices, we usually mean binary on-off devices such as actuators, sensors, rotary encoders, analog inputs and outputs, push buttons and valve position sensors.